handsome, you are welcome. Yebo! Right about now, we are... I'm trying to get away to put yourself. All right, we have a very, very wonderful guest in the house. He was actually talking to me about something. Said he likes my style. He likes the way my trouser is so big. I actually got materials from Tunde's. Let's not talk about that. We have someone interesting in the house, and I'm sure you want to meet him. He is handsome. I love his hairdo. Really good. And he is from Ibadan. And his name is Joshua. Ladies and gentlemen, I be Josh.
Wow. Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
I be Ibadan.
To correct something, I'm not from Ibadan. You understand? IB is actually my surname. Spelled IBITOI. So the first two letters, that's what I used to come up with.
There's nothing there.
But
you know?
Where are you from, by the way?
I'm from Ondo State.
They're the same family, man.
Yeah, definitely.
Not too far from each other. Okay, Josh, what's going on? How are you doing, man?
I'm very fine. How are you?
Nice hair, by the way. How about I say I put sawdust for you?
I love your hair. It's really beautiful.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
You don't even vex. So I'm not this or this. You don't vex.
No, you don't mean it. I don't say you appreciate them now. So,
my man. All right, cool. Let's talk about Yebo.
Okay.
The last song we heard about.
Okay.
What's that one now? What's Yebo? I know Skibo. Baddest, I know that one. But I don't know Yebo.
I know Yebo.
Yebo is not a slang.
Oh, okay.
It's actually a word.
Yes.
Like a South African language, Zulu. Yebo means yes.
Yes.
You understand?
Oh, Yebo.
Oh, so some education for my dear Miles.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Ask me something. Is my name Miles?
It's your name Miles.
Yebo.
Yeah, you understand? That is it.
Now
it means yes.
Okay, cool.
So I used it during the intro. I said, Yebo, that means yes, we are back.
See? Oh, okay. I didn't get that.
Okay, so what kind of music would you say you do?
I do Afro-R&B.
Okay, and?
Understand? Afro-R&B.
Okay, so if I tell you to do some other genre, you not be able to pull it off?
I can, but I major in Afro-R&B. Okay. You have to know your bearing now. Don't be all over the place. Today reggae, tomorrow Fuji. You understand? So
even if you drink a lot of beer, still know your bearing.
Yeah, even if you have a lot of women around you, know the one that you focus on. Men.
Lamba.
Okay, now Afro. Okay. Have you noticed how everybody infuses Afro into everything they say?
Yes.
Afro blues, Afro souls, Afro R&B, Afro pop, Afro rap, Afro trap, Afro every time.
Yeah.
Why?
Afro is just the short form to me for Africa. You understand? So I feel I'm an R&B artist, but I have that African feel in my sound. You understand? You understand? African feel. So that's why it's Afro R&B.
Okay, cool. Yeah. Let's talk about how you met TY Mix now. By the way, I be Josh like this side on the TY Mix's record label.
Okay.
And I'm going to ask you. Yeah. How do you guys think? Were you just singing on the road one day? You know all those kind of stories, like when I was singing on the road, I was eating bread on the road, and he just drove by, just saw me like,
you sing good.
So how did you guys meet?
How did we meet? This is a very funny question, because we're related. You understand? Hey. So I've known him for a very long time, and it happened.
No, wait. Okay, is this a family business kind of thing? Because you're really just like, Joshua sings, so yeah, come, let's just sign you. Or he actually signed you based on merit, like, okay, this boy actually has talent.
Yeah, he signed me based on merit, because the business is a very serious business, music business.
Okay.
If you don't have it, man, don't try to do it. You understand? Because it's serious business. So he saw the seriousness to me and the talent. So I was like, come on.
Sure.
But I had to go to school, because I said I should finish my education.
Ah.
So after I finished my education, I got officially signed last year.
Officially?
Yeah, officially.
Okay, right now, under Vivace Records, you have... is Immaculate still there?
The question should be directed to TY, because I'm just an artist there.
Who are your other team members?
My manager, Mr. Ade.
Okay.
Fantastic man. In-house producer, Holy Dope.
Okay.
Fantastic producer.
Oyinkade.
Direct the question to TY Mix.
TY Mix,
you understand?
Okay.
Now they see you, you go direct them to Abi employee.
Okay, so let me just face the camera. TY Mix, just in case you're watching, I be just didn't know if Oyinkade or Mark is still on the record label. So we want to ask you, we'll find a way to come and ask you. I'm sure you'll flog you. Like, why you no good no now? I be, why you no good no?
Really?
What happened?
I just had a moment. For those of you who want to call in and talk to IB Josh, please call in on 070-0000-RTTV. I repeat, 070-0000-RTTV. You can also tweet at us at R2_TV. Yeah, and Skype in at R2TV.
Okay, Words on the Street says that you have a new joint called My Style. What's
no,
My Style?
Your Style.
Your style.
Baby girl, style. About your style. You understand? It's just a song talking about the fact that you're enjoying the girl. You understand? Like the regular love story. You understand? Like the chorus says, baby girl, I got in your style. You understand? So that says it all. It's just a song about love. Yeah.
Okay, you did drop this because of the season of love, which is Valentine's Day. Or it's just...
Oh, there's a girl who you really love her style.
No, you know... as an artist, it's not every song you sing that is actually your story. You understand?
True.
You're singing for people, and there will be a particular person that is going through that phase at a particular point in time. So your style is just a general love song to anybody that is out there who is feeling the lady's style. Yeah, that is it, basically.
But based on your music, do you think that you're the kind of musical artist who tends to want to put out a particular message, or you just sing about anything that comes to your head at that time?
Especially that girl.
Especially that girl.
It depends on my mood. Understand? It depends on my mood.
If they vex you, right? Angry.
Like if I'm angry with the government, I can just go to the studio and do a song about
the
government.
Why do you
like,
have to mention government? Why can't you just say somebody else? Leave government to go judge.
Okay, but it depends on my mood. Understand how I'm feeling? So I just flow my mood.
Okay. Yeah. Now, in Nigeria right now, there's so many artists upcoming.
Yeah.
The ones that have been there before you.
The ones that are
so-called has-beens. Forgive me, y'all. And some of them have been there for like forever, and they're still relevant up till today. They've been there. Like Two Face has been around for a long time.
Very long.
Timothy Akula has been around for quite a while.
Yeah.
MI, quite a while. So, and they're still very much relevant. They're still there.
Yeah.
So, what is that thing that would make IB Josh stand? Or is it something you just want to do for a while? Like, I'll just think for a while. Let me make some more money and let me go. Or is something you think, oh, this is going to be a career I want to take for a long time? What is that thing that stands IB Josh out? Why will I always want to listen to IB Josh? Why will I come back in 20 years and say, man, IB Josh, man? Did you always bring them? Why will I do that?
Okay, like I said earlier on, my style is Afro-R&B, and there are very few artists with that style. Like every other person wants to do Afro-pop, you know, bang, 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 bang. You understand? I think my style will stand me out, you understand? Because I do quality music. Take a look at Timi Dakolo. You understand? Timi Dakolo has been there for like over 10 years now, and he's still going on strong. You understand? So I think my style, Afro-R&B and content, you understand, and definitely the grace of God will make me last longer in the industry.
Sorry, I always want to ask a question. Anytime I see a musical artist, they say good songs, quality music. What is quality music? Is it based on the lyrics of the song or the instrumentals or how people accept it? What is quality music?
Oh, joy. Like, first of all, from the lyrics to the production, you understand? Because it goes a long way. Lyrics, production, theme of the song, the message of the song.
Okay.
You understand? So I think.
But based on your songs, how has the acceptance been?
Wow, we've been amazing. Loving it. It's been amazing. Like, I'm not even up to a year in the industry. I got signed ending of last year, and
you started making money.
Like, you know, small small now.
But you don't. The money don't enter small small, sir.
We give God the glory. We give God the glory.
It's been amazing. We're going to take the money from you. Why are you trying to be?
No, I'm not going to take them now, but it's been amazing. It's been amazing.
The journey has been good so far.
Yeah,
right?
It's been very good.
Okay, cool. Let's talk about this year now. Now, what kind of body of work are you trying to put out? Are you doing more singles this year? Are you dropping an album this year? Or you still want to test the waters a little bit? Like, let me see. Let them really know me. Then I'll drop an album. Or what's the plan?
Yeah, you said it though. Working on singles.
No album this year. What about collab?
The fans dictate the pace of the album. You don't just drop an album for your family and friends, you understand?
Okay.
When it's right, you know, you feel it. Understand? So I'm dropping singles, videos.
Okay.
Yeah.
I want to ask you a question. When is right? Thank goodness you said that. Now you're saying when it's right, are you saying after the first hit song? Oh, I have a hit song, boom, na 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 na, or I drop another one, Your Style, and it's a hit song. Is that when you think it's actually right to drop an album?
To me, I feel the time I'll drop an album,
once
to me,
they have a hit song, bam.
To me, I feel once I have like 3 hit songs back to back. Because at that point in your career, you'll be on very high demand, and people actually want to listen to what you're doing, you understand? So I think after like 3 hit songs back to back, then I can drop an album.
Okay. I'm going to go back to the album thing. This is not me challenging, I'm just talking about it generally.
Yeah.
Wizkid has just 2 albums,
mm-hmm.
and he spaces them and he's still
everywhere,
making money, yeah, too, everywhere, still doing his thing back to back. So I'm just saying that this having three songs, if you have, even if you have one song or you don't even have, you're just out there, you can drop an album. It doesn't necessarily have to be a 20-something track album. It can, yeah, be just an 11-track album. I just put it out there and be like, okay, this guy is good. Yeah. He's good at what he does.
It depends on how you want to go about it.
Everything, the, has become, everything sounds like a business now.
Olamide has like 6 albums. Very successful. Extremely successful.
Very good.
Wheezy, 2 albums. Very successful. So it depends on how you want to do your own thing. Like, yeah, depends on how you want to do your own thing. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I'm just thinking. You definitely go for concerts and all of that. Yeah. Please, I want you to please share your most embarrassing moments.
Sure.
On stage, maybe you were singing. And
I was there. I watched, that was the performance. I was there. But tell them.
You know, I said it. I
like this guy.
I was performing, man, and I fell off the stage.
I told you.
And this was actually a school,
in Abuja.
I know students
I'm
don't
sure
show love.
In Abuja, ba?
No, it wasn't in Abuja.
No, you want to?
I don't want to call the name of the school.
So like, don't call the name. What area? Where? You don't call the name now. It's Abuja.
It's Abuja.
I was there.
Chama, you be spiritual.
By the way, what happened? Like, were you wearing shades?
Funny enough, I wasn't.
Why they do that? Like, you guys, musical artists, I know it's beautiful and all of that, but I really don't get it. That even you go to a place where it's really dark and you're still wearing them shades.
The reason why I wear dark glasses is not because of Vianga or fashion. It's because of my eyes. I don't have eye problem, but I was always on my laptop for years. And affected my eyes. So right now, when this bright light here now, if I'm not with these glasses, I'll be treating my eyes like this. And it's
when you fell off stage, what happened?
People shouted now, but I stood up and life goes on.
And you continued?
Yeah, I continued.
So let's look at the other part. What has been the peak of your in your career? Like, okay, man, this is major for me.
Yeah, I think so far getting signed, you understand, because it makes it a whole lot easier. Because the industry is very capital intensive. Don't even go there. Like, it's very capital intensive. And being signed to a proper record company that actually know what they are doing is amazing. Like, it's amazing. So,
talking about your record company. Now, do you work with other producers, or is it just T.Y.?
No, T.Y. is open to any producer. Like, I've worked with Holy Dope, and we already have plans to work with other big names. You understand, bro? T.Y., Holy Dope, and anybody who's talented.
Okay, like, on your singles to come, who should we be expected to hear on it? Like collaborations and stuff?
Collaborations on singles. Keep your fingers crossed. Hey, just leave it.
Okay, fingers crossed.
Who is that artist? I don't know him.
See, I just want to ask you one last question. If you were to be the president, of Nigeria, what would you change in the Nigerian music industry? What would you improve? What would you change? What would that thing be?
I think I will just give you more structure, you understand? I'll make it an avenue where an artist can make song not only and make money not only by performing, you understand? Like legal structure, like abroad now,
if it's off download,
like I'll make
sales.
It legal, like abroad now, if you drop a hit song, just one hit song, you can go and sleep, man, because you're getting royalties from
anybody who plays it.
Because Nigerian artists only make money from shows and endorsement deals.
Tell me about it.
I'll just put that in place.
All right. Yeah. So okay, fantastic stuff. It's been nice chatting with.
I be Josh.
I know Jerry.
You know Jerry. Calm down.
Don't spoil my market.
No. Just don't beat me. She's violent.
I'm violent.
She's not. She's very cute. She's
violent. She's dancing. Okay. Now, how do people reach you on all your social media platforms and what are we expecting from IB Josh this 2017?
Okay, on Instagram, my handle is IB_Josh. On Twitter, my handle is IB_Josh. Easy. Instagram, IB_Josh. Twitter, IB_Josh. Like I said, I'm dropping another single next week. Your Style. You understand? Your Style. Then the follow up. Then the video to Your Style. Then follow up singles. So that's how the year we go through. And
hopefully,
by God's grace,
it will all turn
I know
out.
That yeah, there will be a lot of girls in this Your Style video. I can see the picture of the video already.
No.
Wow, see that girl.
No, it's not a video for girls. Like, even if there will be a girl, just one girl. You understand? I can't be saying like Badun Your Style in a video and there are 50 girls. You understand?
Why can't you Badun 50 girls' style?
Thank you.
Why not?
Okay. This chairman.
I'm sitting on the chair. Okay, cool. That's about the whole 9 hours on the show today. Thank you so very much for everybody who's been part of the show. Thank you to IB Ibitoye Joshua for being in the building.
Thank you very much for having me. Thank you. I appreciate
it. Even if they don't put on light, his hair alone will light up the whole
place. Shine bright like a diamond.
He is about to take us out with an amazing song, his new single, Your Style. Now, so we'll come your way tomorrow. Don't move a muscle. Stick to RSU TV.
They should stay there.
You say what?
Till tomorrow, they should not move a muscle.
They should stay there. Be watching RSU TV now.
You can drink.
We gave you something when you came here. Oh, you still have it, Abi?
Yeah.
All right. Cool. So.
Yeah.
Ingo.